the river to pray, studying about that good old way. And who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down. Come on down, come on, sisters, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, fathers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, fathers, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, fathers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, mothers, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sinners, let's go down, come on, come on, sinners, let's go down, down to the river to pray.
Thank you. Well, this morning, we're glad to have you here to pray Jesus Christ and to grow in his image. But may the peace of Jesus be with you. Let us share it with one another.
Jerusalem, just like John. step on the cross, walk in Jerusalem, just like John. Your foot might slip, your soul get lost, walk in Jerusalem, just like John. I wanna be ready, I wanna be ready, I wanna be ready to walk in Jerusalem, just like John.
You know, a lot of us, well, we pray to God for the basic necessities, for healing, for forgiveness, for courage to face the troubles. We come looking for the bread of necessity to feed us, that we might survive from day to day. Oh, God, get me through that exam tomorrow. Lord, help me keep that diet. Jesus, help me put up with the obnoxious cousin I got this week. Oh, Lord, help, help. Get us through the month with no food in the house. Our sense of who God is. Sometimes what we dare to ask. And sometimes kind of limited to a divine skyhook that's going to come down and rescue us in the middle of trouble. And certainly God does do these things at times. But Jesus wants us to know that there is more than this in our relationship with God. So listen.
Please stand for the gospel. The setting for this is after the feeding of the 5,000, Jesus went to the mountain, and his disciples got into the boats and went to Capernaum. The gospel reads, "So when the crowd saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they themselves got into boats and went to Capernaum looking for Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the sea, they said to him, 'Rabbi, when did you come here?' Jesus answered them, 'Very truly I tell you, you were looking for me, not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not work for the food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For it is on him that God the Father has set his seal.' Then they said to him, 'What must we do to perform the works of God?' And Jesus answered them, 'This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent.' So they said to him, 'What sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing? Our ancestors ate manna in the wilderness, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat.' Then Jesus said to them, 'Very truly I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world.' They said to him, 'Sir, give us this bread always.' And Jesus said to them, 'I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty.' The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
This month we're exploring what Jesus has to teach us about the bread of life. We heard today may sound odd to our ears. Jesus speaks to us about the works of God and what they mean for us. It's a mystery that stretches our hearts and minds, but it is really foundational to what Jesus has to teach us. So, what are the works of God? We might think of creation or the deliverance of the Hebrews from Egypt, slavery through the Red Sea. Perhaps we think of Jesus feeding the 5,000, healing the sick. Certainly these are the works of God. But Jesus wants us to experience something more. God is more than a free lunch counter and a dispenser of Band-Aids. The works of God are something in which we are invited to be active participants. It's more than getting free food. It's more than learning how to fish for ourselves. It's an invitation to get on board with God's great work in creation. If we go back to the Garden of Eden stories, remember that God gave our first parents some work to name the critters and to manage the abundance that God had set forth for humanity in the world. And that was interrupted by our idea of playing at God's. We decided that we didn't need God to guide us in anything. We could figure it out for ourselves and just got going all by ourselves. And of course, the more we did, the harder things got. And as God pointed out, what happens is that our work became hard labor and disappointment, pain, and suffering. And we worked on our own plans and suffered the futility of misplaced labor and trust. Sounds strange, but it's really pretty simple. Some of you have worked on Thanksgiving dinner. Some of you have been in charge of Thanksgiving dinner. Right? Or another big event where food is being prepared for a lot of people. Now you want everybody who's working on that to be on the same page. You want them to be working together to get that meal ready and on the table in time. What happens if somebody decides to go off on some culinary expedition of their own? Something doesn't get done. Something isn't right. Maybe there's no gravy, maybe there are no potatoes, maybe the bird doesn't arrive on time to be cooked. Who knows? But that's how it is in our relationship with God. God might be the master chef and we're running around creating hors d'oeuvres that really don't feed us that well. It's a problem that affects us all. But Jesus invites us to get back with God's program, to join God in God's what God is already doing in the world. Instead of demanding that God fix our messes day by day. So what is God's program? The answer to that question turns out to be pretty simple. It's Jesus. Jesus is the one who's carrying out God's plan for healing the world and everything that's in it. Getting on board is allowing Jesus to feed us inwardly. The faith of Jesus is what connects us to God's plan. If we allow this to work within us through the Holy Spirit, we find ourselves in the groove with God. So Jesus, when he's asked questions, says, this is the work of God that you believe in him who he has sent. You know, there are too many pronouns in there. And they're all guy pronouns, right? But it really means if we believe in Jesus, we have an opportunity to do the work of God. It's not a big doctrinal or dogmatic thing. It means simply putting your trust in Jesus. How do we do that? Well, If you're asked to jump out of a window of a burning building into a net, what do? You have to trust the people holding the net, and you have to trust the net. I'm not sure I would. If you get in a car or a bus or a train or an airplane, you have to trust that the driver knows what he or she is doing and that the vehicle is safe. Putting trust in Jesus is not a big deal. It's just like that. Can you trust that Jesus is there for you? That Jesus is leading us in the right direction? You know, we trust in the scientific process to give us useful information and technology. Could we trust that Jesus connects us to God's purpose for the universe? Jesus is the bread of life because it is through his faithfulness to the Father that we're able to experience connection to God and the divine order of things. We don't need to understand everything scientifically, although that is useful. We need to place our trust in the working of the Holy Spirit within us. What a gift. Anyone can receive this, no matter who you are, what you've done, where you come from. So we're going to be talking about this over the next coming weeks, but let us taste the blessing of this relationship today. If I trust in Jesus, I allow the Spirit to guide me so I can face the challenges of today without fear and worry and anger. If I trust Jesus to lead me toward God's order, I do not need to fret over the way things are going wrong all around me. If I trust in Jesus, I can take risks and try new ways of living that share love and generosity and hospitality to people who are different. If I trust in Jesus, I do not need to judge others or judge myself. If I trust in Jesus, I can calmly face death and disease and grief. If I trust in Jesus, I can take stands without fear, stands against those with power who threaten the poor, the weak, and the powerless. If I trust in Jesus, I can experience true freedom and all the fruits of the Spirit. Now, I'm sure you remember from Sunday school, some of you, what those are. Not. Love. Joy. Peace. Patience. Kindness. Gentleness. Goodness, faithfulness, self-control. Think about that. These are the things that come from trust. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Now, if we can have that by trusting Jesus, can we not face the world around us as it seems to be going nuttier by the day? Can we face the world in which there are insufficiencies for many people, where there is not enough food or shelter or safety or medicine? Can we face the world? Yes. Because we have that inner strength that takes what it takes to live life. Some of you may know people in your family or acquaintance who have gone through a really rough time, and you've been amazed at how did they do it. And you're amazed at how calm they seem in the midst of challenges and troubles. When I was very small, my younger sister decided to pick up a glass and swallow an ice cube. We were on Cape Cod, and it was the four of us with my parents. And my father freaked out. He didn't know what to do. My mother took my sister over her lap and knocked the ice cube out of her mouth, saved her life. She was calm, She was clear. She knew what to do. I think afterwards she was a total wreck. But each one of us knows of those times when we get clarity in our lives, when we trust what we have to trust in order to get it done. You know, there are some people who are kind of bossy, annoyingly bossy. But if you have a crowded room and there's a fire and that person stands up, you know you're all going to get out of there alive, because that person is going to direct you to get out. You know what I'm saying? Somebody who just has the clarity to get that done. They might be a little trouble around the dinner table, but they get you out in a crisis. But that's where some of the other virtues come in, these fruits of the Spirit. So, my friends, if you would like to experience more of those fruits of the Spirit, try trusting Jesus in the context of some problem that hits you, some stress that comes up in your life. And when you feel like smacking somebody and your mind overcomes your body's natural inclination to do that, trust Jesus instead and feel that energy of anger slip away. You might just discover that you were wrong or that there really isn't that kind of a problem in the first place. A lot of the problems in the world can be addressed when we practice this. So if you want the bread of life, if you want to be nurtured in something that gives you a life that's worth living, start trusting Jesus. Amen.
Be joyful, my friends.
Éternel Dieu tout, de toute puissance, omnipotent, omnicréant, le Dieu d'amour, nous t'appelons la manne cachée, nous t'appelons l'eau de vie, nous t'appelons Jésus-Christ, tu es le ressuscité du troisième jour. Nous disons merci pour cette bonne journée. Merci pour les dimanches où nous t'adorons, nous te glorifions. Nous élevons nos voix et nous disons, sois béni, sois exalté, le Seigneur des Seigneurs. Oui, mon Dieu, tu es saint, tu es saint, tu es saint, le Seigneur de l'univers. Et tout le monde entier élève la voix. Tous les genoux fléchissent à ton nom. Tu es l'omnicréant, l'omnipotent, l'omniscient. Nous te disons merci pour cette bonne parole. Ô Seigneur, nous venons devant toi. Nous voulons que tu nous combles des fruits de cet esprit. La patience, la paix, la joie, l'amour. Que notre cœur soit comblé de votre amour. La paix qui surpasse toute intelligence du monde qui vient de toi, mon Dieu, mon roi. Sans toi, Jésus, nous ne pouvons rien faire. Avec toi, Jésus, nous ferons des exploits. Que ton Esprit Saint nous guide. Ô Seigneur, bénis-nous tous. Bénis cette assemblée. Sois au milieu de nous, au nom et pour l'amour de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ. Amen.
Down into darkness, open my eyes, let me see the beauty that made this heart adore you, hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. All days, oh, so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became poor. Here I am. Here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. And I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon the cross, and I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon the cross. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether loved.
altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Wonderful voice, wonderful playing. Thank you. You know, we get going in life and we find ourselves way off God's reservation, as it were. We're out there causing trouble that we didn't even know was trouble because we're trying to do the right thing in the wrong place at the wrong time. Sometimes we just have to lift that up to God and ask for Jesus' forgiveness and know that His love covers us. I invite you to do that now. Friends, know that Jesus loves you, that you are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen. Christ our Lord invites to his table everybody. Everybody indeed. Who seeks to be at peace with God and with one another. We're all invited to this table where we're invited to experience the presence of God with us. And so after our prayers together, you are invited to come forward and stand or kneel as you are comfortable and to receive and look for the encounter with God. It might be silence, it might be words, it might be images, it might be feeling.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is all right, a good and joyful thing. Always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Oh Lord, you created us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. We turned away and our love failed, but your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity. You fed us bread in the desert. You led us through the sea and into a land flowing with milk and honey. You spoke to us through your prophets who looked for the day when justice would roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ.
Your Spirit anointed him to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives, recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty all who are oppressed, and to announce that the time has come when you will save your people. He healed the sick and fed the hungry. He ate with sinners, and by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church and delivered us from slavery to sin and death, making with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit.
On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took the bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many, for forgiveness of sins. Do this as you often as you drink it in remembrance of me.
And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on this gift of bread and wine. Make them before us the body and blood of Christ, that we may before the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The body of Christ for the people of Christ.
Amen.
The cup of blessing, that you may live and prosper.
Amen.
Gluten-free, it's available on this side, just request it. Body and blood of Christ. You may come forward.
Let us pray together. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this moment's grace in which you've given close to us. Great God, we give ourselves for others in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
May the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. May the Holy Spirit fill you, and may the peace of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you always. Go and serve Christ in the world. Amen.
Ralph, I forgot to...
Steve, for leading us this week. It's been wonderful and beautiful and fantastic, and you even let the Austin take off, and that was really cool.
Circle, draw the circle.